in parliament. But for this climate action, all parties agreed and we levied carbon tax. So that is why I say that India is walking the talk. We have increased solar production, we have increased renewable portion, we have lowered the cost, we have imposed carbon tax on coal, we have brought prices down of LED also, improving energy efficiency. Simultaneously, we are giving a big e-push. I am the Minister for Heavy Industries, which looks after this electric push. So electrical vehicles are growing, their prices also coming down, and we are also raising infrastructure of battery charging, because in electrical car spread, it is always chicken and egg situation. What is first, chicken or egg? So we are already installing sufficient amount of battery infrastructure, electrical charging infrastructure, and we have also adopted a policy of battery swapping. So we will go ahead with our program in electrical vehicles. The three-wheelers have become very popular. Two-wheelers are also picking up, and four-wheelers we have a target, and we are also giving subsidy for electrical buses, which are operating in many cities, and we will have 5,000 of electrical buses very soon. So this is what India is doing on front of energy. It's huge, but I want to point out, we have already asked power plants to install FGD mechanism, but when we were discussing that, it was noticed that it has a huge cost. If your power project is 660 megawatt capacity, you require 330 crores rupees, 50 lakh rupees per megawatt. It's a huge cost. And what it tackles? It essentially tackles sulfur emissions. So sulfur emission, our Indian coal has very less content of sulfur. And therefore, whether this is appropriate technology for India or not is a question. We are ready to adopt latest, but country-specific and country-appropriate technology. Otherwise, what is appropriate in Europe may not be appropriate in India. And second is cost of technology. You cannot have exorbitant cost and therefore exorbitant profit from disaster, likely disaster. When we talk seriously about climate change, what we say is that, yes, there is disaster to happen. If we want to avoid that disaster, then we must make technologies available at an affordable cost. International Energy Agency also must try in this direction, that all these carbon sequestration, carbon usage and storage, all these technologies which will come on 800 technologies have to be affordable. If they are not affordable, it will not spread. And fortunately, we are at the stage where we can leapfrog, like we have done in transport sector, from BS4 to BS6, that is equivalent to Euro 6. We have already jumped and skipped one stage, and we have invested huge amount of more than $10 billion in these programs. So this transition from BS4 to BS6 of fuel, and now our cars and vehicles are also BS6 compliant. from 1st April. So this is how India is progressing on its commitments and ensuring that there will be lesser and lesser emissions from all resources. In industry also, we are talking to various groups of industries for how, what should be their individual plan of action so that their emissions are reduced. We are monitoring their emissions, we are correcting them, but we want to have new technologies at an affordable cost. And for that also, world which promised in 2009 $100 billion per year, now it is $1 trillion and $100 billion. 1 trillion, 10 years, and nothing is on the table actually. And therefore, my final point is that we are walking the talk. The technologies have to be country specific, appropriate technology at an affordable cost. There have to be more real technological collaborations. India is willing. And at the same time, there has to be finance on the table. As we will continue on our path to energy efficiency and to reduce emission intensity by 30%, 35% by 2030, we will stick to our program and even overachieve. But global stocktake will happen in 2023. So raising ambition by any country, the issue arises only after 2023. And therefore, with this, I can say that your today's deliberations are important. We will study all the technologies available and we will use them, give them freedom to come to India, barring there should be appropriate technologies at an appropriate cost. Thank you and all the best.
Thank you very much, Mr. Minister. If I may, before going to Dr. Öge, two remarks based on your excellent speech. One is, Mr. Minister, I want to make it clear. My position, IEA's position on climate change is very, very clear. We know that this is an